really understands his body and knows what it takes. It won't be the first sort of injury that he's sort of recovered from or even played with, you know. So he knows his body, and obviously we'll have a big say in that process of returning, and we'll work together with him.
Of course, those injuries aren't ideal ahead of the season, but after your first pre-season with the side, where do you kind of assess the team are at the moment as you start the season?
Well, that will be shown in the games. Obviously, you never quite know. I've had a few pre-seasons now, and I've gone into them feeling full of confidence, and maybe I've not had the start that I thought we would get, and I've had the opposite as well, where, you know, definitely haven't got to the levels in pre-season, and then started the season, you know, much better than what I thought. So so you never quite know until the games start. What I do know is that the guys did amazing last year in terms of bouncing back and winning the league and getting back to the Premier League. And there's a real excitement and good vibe about being back in the league, but also a strong motivation to show their worth again, you know, in the league. And I guess that's the feeling around the club, including myself. And we need to channel all that now, starting with Monday night and onwards from there.
In terms of those injuries, though, Steve, with the window 2 weeks left until it closes, how important do you think it is to reinforce that area of the team?
Well, every season you want to, you know, you want to reinforce, you want to strengthen, you want to change. Every club will be the same. We're no different, and we're still going through that process. There's no doubt about that. But you know, the club's working together. Communication lines are great, and I think in general it's been quite a slow market, and maybe we felt that a little bit as well. But not been through a lack of trying. But if I'm being honest, once I knew this week that there probably wouldn't be any additions in terms of Monday night, I sort of put that to one side and really just focusing now on Monday night, you know, because that's the only thing that we can influence. And that's where, like I said, our concentration is, that's where our motivation is, and you know, that's enough to occupy our mind and our days, and that's where we want to be.
Just finally from you, I know your concentration is on Monday night, but how confident are you you'll be able to bring in those numbers before the window, and are there any areas in particular you're looking at?
Yeah, like I said, a standard answer from every manager, you know, and I guess for a team, although we, Leicester, have had many years in the Premier League and are not like newcomers, if you like, it is normal that when you come from the Championship that you do want to, you know, strengthen the squad and you want to add to the team, and we're no different. So that's what we intend to do. And like I said, guys did amazing last year, and you know, they're really looking forward to applying their work now in the Premier League. And if we can add to what is already good at the club and support them, then that's what we'll be hoping to do. But like you said, there's a couple of weeks left, but I'm not really thinking about that now. I'm just focused on Monday and focused on the guys, and because that's, in the meantime, that's the only thing we can control. Thanks, Dan.
Cheers, Dan. We'll go to Damien from PLP.
Hi, Dan. You all right?
You've been linked with a lot of players over the summer. And Plonsek is not going to be one of them who's going to make the move. How frustrating has this period been for you?
Well, I think I can't say that I've followed everything that's out there, not just with us, with any club. So I don't know exactly what's being said. It's probably, respectfully, a mixture of some of the truth and some rumours and some things that are nowhere near the truth as well. So, listen, you know, that old cliche, I'm probably only going to talk about the guys I know are definitely joining or have joined. If I was to talk about one player in that circumstance, then I'd have to probably talk about a dozen others, and there's no point in that because, like I said, some of it might be true, some of it might not. So what's more important is Monday night. Okay, I get it, it's a transfer window and there's the chance of bringing players in, and we want to do that. Club's working very hard. Let's see what next week brings now, because nothing's going to happen before Monday.
I know you can't say too much about PRS, but having been through that at Nottingham Forest, how well placed are you personally to negotiate some of those chopping
boards? Sorry, say that again. Okay.
But you've been through it with Forest. How well placed are you to deal with that
Well, I didn't really. It was after I'd left. If you remember, it was the second part of the season, I think. So that's not something. It's something that's new to me. You're right in the question. I can't talk about it because I don't know much about it. What I do know is that the guys are really focused, and you know we are all aware that there's something out there that gets spoken about. There's no point in saying that we don't know that is the case. But we are also really clear on the fact that it's not going to influence today's training or tomorrow's preparation and the game on Monday night. And really, that's what we've got to concentrate on. So if there's any other news that I that the club want me to talk about, I will. But at the moment, there's not. All we can do is concentrate on the football and the squad and the team. And like I said, there's a real positive vibe around the training ground. There's a real excitement about being back in the Premier League, and for us, you know, that's the headlines of our thoughts, and you know, that's enough to contend with. I was going to crack a joke there, but I thought better not. Yeah.
After 6 months away, what is the sense of excitement for you personally, returning to the Premier League, a big home game against Tottenham?
Sorry, I can't hear you. I can't wait to get back. You know, some of you guys in the room will know. I'm not it's not natural for me to think too much about myself. I always think about the organisation or the club that I work for and what's important to them, because that's the obligation for me. That's a natural way of the way I think and behave. It's always the club first. But you know, the Premier League is a brilliant place to be. I missed it. There's no doubt about that. For the 6 months, I didn't sort of use the time to, you know, down tools or take a break. I didn't. You know, it's the last thing I wanted. But it was a time that I tried to use wisely in terms of preparing for the next role. And here we are now at Leicester City. And it's an exciting challenge, a good challenge. It's one that I knew it was what it was I wanted to do. And like I said, it's been a good pre-season whilst sort of transitioning back to becoming a Premier League team. You know, really looking forward to continuing that challenge. The next step of the season starting.
Thanks a lot. Good luck.
Thanks, Dave.
Cheers, Dave. We'll go to Jason from TalkSport.
Pass the mic.
To your left.
Damien, you've been having a bad day, mate. You're having a bad day.
Steve, good to see you again.
Likewise.
As a club, as a team, are you ready?
Well, that's the intention for sure. What I do know is that we are, like I already said, this is a very hard-working group, a very together group of players, which is natural and normal after a successful season, which is, you know, of course, what happened last season. So we very much want to keep a lot of that going while balancing the challenge of the Premier League and what might need to change and adapt, because obviously it's a completely different challenge. It's the step from Championship to Premier League is a huge one. But, you know, we've got a nice mixture of some guys that have been there before and some guys that are going into there for the first time. And you know, that adds a nice variety of personal motivation. So to answer your question, everything has been gearing to being ready. But, you know, time will tell, you know. But that's not just us. We play Spurs on Monday and then lots of other games before us, obviously, with the last game to go for the first round. We're all in the same boat. But the intentions, of course, is that, we're ready.
Has anyone got a point to prove? Certainly those players that may have gone down a couple of years ago. Do you think they've got something extra to give this season, perhaps?
Well, I think there's always a point to prove. There's always a personal goal and a personal motivation that's obviously linked with the team objectives and goals as well. I think that's always the case, you know, whether, you know, there'll be some guys that are playing in the Premier League again, and you know, want to show that they're back where they should be. And there's some guys in there for the first time that want to show that they worked hard to get it, and they also deserve to be here. So I think to answer your question, yeah. But that's just sort of high performance. That's just elite sport. You've always got, you know, a goal to strive for. And, you know, we have our team goals, or club goals, if you like, that we've agreed on. But in that, of course, there'll be some individual stories as well of how players have, you know, come back to the Premier League or have got there for the first time. And it's nice to sort of understand that. And it's good for each other to understand each other's stories as well, because I think that's then how you become a team and you have each other's back.
You mentioned you were there. Jamie Vardy for Monday and possibly the first few weeks. Patson Daka, you've said as well, for a few months. Tom Cannon also, I guess, improving at this level, good championship striker so far. Where are goals going to come from this season?
Well, of course, you know, the normal answer to that is from the guys at the top end of the pitch, and it's not the perfect situation in terms of number nines going into this game. So there's no point in hiding away from that, but you know, we have to find a way. We have to find the right strategy for the game plan against Spurs to make sure that we can be a threat. Obviously, Spurs are a really good team and play in a defined way. But we've also got to believe in our way and some of the things that we're doing. Believe that they can have a massive impact on the game, including the top end of the pitch and creating and scoring goals. So, and that just isn't the striker. Of course, they can be the main guy, they can be the focal point, all of them things. But it's how you get it to the striker and how you get it to other guys at the top end of the pitch as well. What I do know is we've got enough players more than capable of making a difference in the top end of the pitch. Let's hope we can get the right plan to try and get the best out of them.
Everyone's been making their predictions online, doing the tables, where everyone's going to finish this season, including us at TalkSport. Sorry to say that most are saying that Leicester will be relegated at the end. Do you relish that, though, being written off?
Well, I've had it before, that's for sure, so it's not a new thing for me. And wasn't the case. So let's hope that's the same this year.
Just finally for me, on transfers, you've said, you know, it's been a difficult market. Do you feel, though, that you're where you expected to be? You're getting all the support that you needed from, you know, upstairs?
Yeah, it's a very, like I've said, on a number of occasions now, it is a very aligned club. You can see that from top to bottom, and you can also understand why this club has had the success that it's had, you know, in its Premier League history, because of the way it's run and the communication lines, and that's what I'm feeling. Obviously, there's always context to a present moment, and the context at the moment is trying to contribute to what the guys did last year and just making us, you know, a stronger team and squad for the Premier League, and that is the context, you know. So everybody's working hard, communication lines are clear. There's definitely some things that haven't gone our way, which has not been the club's fault. Let's hope that, you know, we can be a little bit more fortunate in the next couple of weeks, and when that window's shut, we can be where we want to be. But all of that at the moment is irrelevant today, because we, you know, we got a game to prepare for on Monday, and you know, we really believe in the guys that are here. I'll say again, I've said it numerous times, did amazing last year and what they did. You know, they feel good about themselves, and let's hope that we can take that good feeling and good work into the first game of the season.
Cheers, Steve. Have a good season.
You too, mate.
Thanks, Jason. We're going to Owen from Radio Leicester.
So, hi, Steve.
Yeah, you all right?
See you again. You mentioned already, transfer-wise, that you found out that there would be no players coming in before Monday. When did you find that out this week?
Well, the rules say they have to be registered. I meant Monday's game. You have to be registered by midday on a Friday. And obviously, you know, you more or less know a few days before that, because it's a process. Once a deal is agreed, or, you know, a player agrees to come, it doesn't just happen. There's a lot of things that need to be done in terms of medical and certain registrations, et cetera, et cetera. So, yeah, it's not like it just, you know, appears and they sign and that's it. It's a real process. So we knew pretty early on in the week that it was going to be unlikely. And okay, that's fine. We were focusing anyway on the guys and giving them everything, and they deserve that. Yeah, that's been the focus of our work all week, really.
You said you said to me after the Lons game last weekend that you desperately wanted players through the door. The players wanted that that challenge as well. I wonder what messages you've had from the key people who make those deals happen, the recruitment staff, director of football.
No, but that's normal. That's a normal thing to, like I said before, to come from the Championship to the Premier League. You always want to. Well, at the end of any season, really, you reflect on what you think the squad might need for the next season, whatever the challenge is. In our circumstance of coming from the Championship to the Prem, you want to add, you want to strengthen, but support the guys who did a great job last year. So that wasn't just last Saturday's information. No, that's been the information all summer, not just from me, for everybody, because it's a normal thing to do. And we're still in that process, but fortunately, there's a few weeks to go. You know, if we can have a bit more luck, then you know we'll be able to support the guys and become, you know, even stronger than what we are now. But at the moment, that's not in my mind because of a Monday.
You mentioned already that clearly that you are without Patson Daka and Jamie Vardy ahead of the game on Monday against Lons over the weekend when Patson had to come off. You opted for Steffi Mavadidi to come and lead the line instead of Tom Cannon. I wonder how you view that role and what attributes you like from that kind of profile at the top of the pitch.
Yeah, I think like you have to be careful a little bit with pre-season because it is still, you know, particularly in the modern game now where so many players are returning a little bit later and you're trying to get the collective up to a position that they're sort of more or less ready physically for the season. So, and that was a little bit where the team was last week in terms of that we started with was still about getting everybody up to speed. So it wasn't necessarily about what was the right team for that game or the right team for the Spurs game and things like that. So that wasn't just on the change when Pato went off. That was the whole part of the planning. Anyway, and that is pre-season, you know. You want to play really well, you want to score goals, you want to keep clean sheets, you want to win games if you like, but there's also a plan that you have to stick to in terms of trying to get the squad or certainly the guys that you think are going to contribute all in a position where they can. And that sometimes can mean some not normal decisions with positions that players might play in, et cetera, et cetera. So, but we've gone through that process now. Now we're into competition mode. And like for sure, we have to find a solution and a plan, you know, to play against Spurs on the weekend.
And looking ahead to Monday, in terms of your game against Tottenham, what have you made to them in your analysis and the kind of elements of your game you have to get right to come away with a good result?
Yeah, well, they're obviously a really, really good team and playing a defined way with some positions on the pitch that are really fixed and some other positions that are really fluid and we're fully aware of that and we'll be ready for that. But we've also got to make sure that we're at home. It's the first game of the season. We've worked incredibly hard to get back in the league. We've continued that through pre-season. So we really want to be focusing on what we can do in terms of having the right influence, impact on the game. And that's where our focus is. But, yeah, of course, you know, Spurs have got some brilliant players and, you know, really good manager and defined way of playing. But that's going to be the case every single week in the Premier League. And if you, of course, you respect and you have to understand what the opponent does, but it can never outweigh what you want to do yourself. And that's exactly where our mindset is.
And finally, you mentioned a few moments ago the goals that you've set the players this season. I wonder whether you mind sharing those with us, what they look like.
No, they're. We decided to keep that in internal. I'm quite happy to say that we had a good sort of a good day on it, really. You know, and there was some real good engagement from the players, and some players really opened up on talking about, you know, what we want to achieve this year. And there was a good debate around it. It was good discussion and good honesty. And we agreed, you know, and it's really important for me that players have a voice in these sort of things, and they do, and that's great. We've set them. We've also talked about how we achieve them And that's where our focus is. We're in control of that. And, you know, let's make sure we commit to it.
Steve,
you too. Thank you.
Thanks, Owen. We'll wrap up the broadcast section with one from Colin from BBC East Midlands.
Colin?
Hi. There's always an assumption, I think, with teams, always an assumption with teams that come up, that they're going to struggle. We know things are tight here. What sort of optimism can you offer to the fan base?
I feel a good optimism anyway. You know, I've spent quite a bit of time around the stadium. I've attended.